Good morning. Hope you are all well. Welcome back. Today we're going to have a look at the design of electrical machines. Now, if you look at the main specifications of an induction motor, we are looking at the number of phases, the frequency, the rated output in kilowatts, the voltage, starting current, power factor, and efficiency. The type of connections that we are having, temperature rise, and the speed and the pull-out torque, and the insulation class. If you look at the induction motor design, we are going to look at the main dimensions of the stator or the rotor. Let D be the bore diameter of the stator, which is the outer diameter of the rotor, L the length of the stator, or the rotor. The air gap is ignored in this work. And data pertains to induction motor and the synchronous motor. Now let's look at the rating of an induction motor. S is V times I times 10 to the power of minus 3 kilovolt amps per phase. Now V is more or less equal to E, which is equal to 2.22 times kW, times the flux, times the conductors, times the number of revs per second, times the number of poles, times 10 to the power of minus 3 kilovolt. Now we substituted that into the first equation and we get S is equal to 2.22 kW phi ZnSP times I times 10 to the minus 3. Now if we divide by Ns, then we get the kVA per rev, which is 2P phi times IZ times KF, KP, and KD. So, and the watts per rev is K times TML times TL. TML is your total magnetic load, and TEL is your total electric load. Let's look at the output of the machine for a three-phase machine. Sorry. S is equal to 3 times 2 kF kW phi ZnS P times I times 10 to the minus 3. Now the specific magnetic load B is equal to the flux over the area, and that is equal to the flux times tau P times L, where tau P is the pole length. But tau P is pi D over 2P, and therefore the average can be said, sorry, is 2P phi over pi D L. Q is our total ampere conductors per meter of the circumference, and therefore Q is equal to 3IZ over pi D. So therefore, S divided by NS is equal to B average times D times I times Q pi D times I times KF KW. That gives us D squared L, B average Q pi squared times I times KF times KW, which is equal to D squared L times G, where G is the output coefficient, and D squared over L is S over GnS. This means that the output is directly proportional to the volume of the rotor. Initially, kW is unknown, and we assume it to be 0.955. So we still have Q is equal to 3IZ over pi D. And we use the RMS value of the current. SEL depends on I square R losses and armature reaction effects. Also on the type of insulation, ventilation, and cooling method. So therefore, S is equal to 6.66 kW phi max Z phase F times I phase times 10 to the power of minus 3 kVA. And S is normally P divided by the efficiency divided by N equals phi. So therefore S is KFKW times 3IZ times 2 P phi over NS times 10 to the minus 3. So that becomes KFKW pi DQ P average times pi DL times N times 10 to the minus 3 by rearranging. And then we get KFKW is pi squared D average D squared L times Q times NS times 10 minus 3. And therefore we can calculate G, which is S divided by KFKW pi squared P average Q T squared L NS times 10 to the power of minus 3. Let's look at an example. Determine the main dimensions for a three-phase, four-pole, 50 hertz, 7.5 kilowatt, 450 volt delta connected, class A insulation, continuous rated, direct online starting, squirrel cage induction motor. So there we have the data. In efficiency is 88%, revs is 1440 revs per minute, power factor is 0.87, kW is 0.95, V is 0.45 tesla, diameter is 165 millimeter, and Q is 23 kiloampere per meter. So therefore S will be P divided by efficiency equals 5, which gives us 9.8 kVA. NS is 60F over P, that gives us 3000 over 2 is 1500 revs per minute, which is 25 revs per second. Now we know the formula by now. S is KF, KW, pi squared, P average, D squared, I, L, Q, N, S, 10 minus 3. Now, if you substitute it in there, we get that L is 133 millimeters. Then compute the main dimensions of a three-phase, 450 volt, 75 kilowatt, 50 hertz, delta connected, slip ring induction motor. The following data is applicable. Efficiency is 90%, power factor is 0.88. KW is 0.95, the average flux density is 0.5 tesla, Q is 38 kiloampere per meter, and the diameter is 0.325. Again, S is P divided by the efficiency equals phi, that gives us 94.9697 kVA. Our speed is 1,000 revs per minute, which is 16.667 revs per second. S is KF, KW, pi squared, B average, D squared, L, I, Q, N, S, times 10 minus 3. Substitute it in the formula, and we get that the length of the rotor is 273 millimeters. Sorry. Now, if you look at salient pole rotor design, the rotor consists of coils in series, two types of voltages, the excitation voltage and the coil voltage. So our coil is rho L, the mean length times the number of turns per coil times the area of the conductor. IMT is the mean length per turn, AC, area of the conductor, and coil is the turns per coil. So the MMF of the coil is the N coil times I field. R coil is V coil divided by IF. So we have V voltage of the coil is rho LMT F times coil times AC. V coil is V coil times IF. Maximum temperature is C times P coil divided by S. Where C is our cooling coefficient, and P coil is the heat generated. S is the area of the pole shank, which is the area times the height. The length of the gap can be calculated with this empirical formula. It is 0.2 plus 2 square root D times L. Then let's look at the coolant necessary. Q is 0.003 P divided by the inlet temperature times the maximum temperature plus 273. Q is the amount of coolant necessary per cubic meter per second. P is the heat to be dissipated. Theta in is the inlet temperature of the coolant. And theta max is the maximum temperature rise of the machine. And the efficiency is rho Q over P of the fan. Rho is the pressure in megapascal. And let's look at an example. A 30 MVA alternator has a power factor of 0.8 lagging and a full load efficiency of 0.97. The maximum temperature rise is 32 degrees and the inlet temperature is 25 degrees. The efficiency of the fan is 40% and rho is 3 kilopascal. So P is S cos phi divided by the efficiency, which gives us 24.7423 megawatt. The losses is the output minus the input, which is then 742.3 kilowatt. So if we stick it in the formula, we get the efficiency of the, or the power of the fan necessary is 203.76 kilowatt. Now, if we look at transformer design, we need the kVA rating, the number of phases, the rated voltage, the current power factor, and the connection type. The losses on no load and full load, cooling methods, temperature rise, the class of insulation, tappings, impedance voltage efficiency at full, 3/4 and a half load at unity power factor, and the regulation at 75 degrees. All right, we'll go on with the next one. Thank you.